Everyone, welcome back to another scrapbook layout, and welcome to week two of Allison Davis's 6x6 sketch class. A lot of you have left comments that you're part of this class, and I think that's totally awesome. I can't wait to see what everybody does. I can't really comment. I don't feel like it's really my place to comment on everybody's, it's kind of Allison's thing to kind of be in charge of all that. But it is so much fun to see the way everybody else is interpreting these sketches. So I got this one finished a little bit sooner this week, and that made me quite happy. I had pulled out birthday photos, but the birthday collection I had planned to use them with, I decided I didn't want to do it. And I had this newer one from Doodlebug. It lost my brain. Couldn't figure out the word doodlebug for a second there. I have this one, and this is their boy birthday collection. They also have a girl one, and I will leave links to these below. And I am in love with this collection. I'm going to be able to use, I think, every last little tiny bit. I'm trying my best. I'm trying really, really hard to not order more of this collection. It's, you know me, I love Doodlebug, but it's just an excellent birthday collection. So yeah, check out the links below. The girl collection is just as great. I apologize to those of you who were there with my little scrapbook stores crop. I did tell you I would use the girl collection next on my channel. My to-do list for things with my channel is kind of long at the moment, so I will get around to using the girl collection. Just, it's going to be a little bit of time. So I do apologize if I come across photos and I can use them for any of these sketches. What I basically did for this 6x6 sketch class was I kind of went through the area in my room where I have kind of basically stuff that I just want to use it up that's older. I'm not that crazy about it. I just can get one or two more layouts of it, and then I'm done. I don't want it anymore. And so I went through that area to try to get these used up. Like I mentioned, I had a birthday collection, a different one picked out to use with these photos. Well, that collection was, I don't know, at least 10 years old, and there wasn't much to it. There was like two pieces of ephemera and stuff. And I said, you know what? I want to use the stuff that I enjoy. I don't want to use the stuff that I'm just forcing myself to use. I want to use this new stuff. So I put that stuff to the side. What I'll do with it, I don't know right now. I think I'll just intermingle it with my collection or colored, like where I keep my colored patterns that really aren't part of a collection or something like that. I'm not going to worry about it right now. It's put away. And I did this collection, and I love how this layout turns out. So I'm very happy that I used what I was inspired by. So I'm going to stop right there and talk about the layout, and you guys can just kind of watch what I'm doing, and then I'll come back to the layout. But I have to say thank you to all of you out there. I posted my last video, and you guys could tell that I was feeling down. I was not excited about doing these layouts. I didn't want to even do them because of the new software. And a lot of you said this software seems to be working fine. I know the voice fluctuates at times. I think I actually will invest in a microphone. I think that will help, just because, I've been doing these videos for a while, and I'm not going to go out and buy some really expensive microphone anyways, but that doesn't matter. What I want to say is thank you, because I read all your guys' kind comments and your wonderful words, and it got me so inspired. In fact, I came right into my room. Well, there's a little bit of a funny story. So I came right into my scrap room. I replied to a whole bunch of you, and I came right in my scrap room and got right to work on this sketch, and I loved it. I had so much fun. It was inspired. I was happy. Then the funny thing is, after you guys all got me inspired to really give it a try and not worry so much, I went to upload all these videos onto my computer, and it wouldn't let me. And my husband was busy and stressed at work, and my son wasn't any help. So I just started bawling my head off. Hormones aren't helping with that. I'm going to just small disclosure there, but, I just really want to say thank you to all of you, because you guys reminded me why I do the videos. I'm not in it to become some famous, YouTuber. It's fun to see the amount of YouTubers or subscribers that I have. It's a lot of fun to watch that number grow up. I'm not going to lie. It is a lot of fun, but I've made connections through this YouTube channel and connections that are amazing to me. And I've met some of you people, not in person, but spoken to some of you, and all the wonderful comments that you guys leave me, it reminded me why I'm doing these in the first place. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm back to scrapbooking. And I'm gonna, like I said, a lot of you seem totally fine with my voice and said this software was working fine and I know how to use it. So in the meantime, I might dabble in learning another software, but I'm not going to worry about being on a time limit for doing so, because you guys made me feel so much better about it. So I can't thank you guys enough. Yeah, I think that's all I was going to say about that. But anyways, I did take this sketch. I think I probably took a little inspiration from Allison Davis, the one she uploaded to Facebook, because she basically, the sketch had the photos at the top and the pattern papers at the bottom. But I kind of didn't want to do it that way. I think I was thinking I liked the way she did it a little better. And I'm really glad that I flipped it. So I'm putting my photos on the bottom and my pattern papers at the top. And I just picked, luckily I had the 6x6 pad for this collection. Like I said, I'm really holding off not buying any more of this collection. It is a great birthday collection though. What I want is more of the full 12x12s, because there's a lot of double pages that I could do that call for more 12x12. And if you want to see a good example of how I kind of combat that, then wait for my video on the 15th, or no, sorry, it's on the 20th now this year, for my love of crafting and sharing videos that I'm going to do. You're going to kind of see where I run into the part where, dang, I wish I had two of those 12 by 12s. There's a few of them, because one thing that Doodlebug did, I don't know if you noticed, I cut that journaling card there with the candles. They made a full 12 by 12 with just journaling cards. And I love it. Oh, it's one of the best things. I hope all these other collections take inspiration from that, because I love having a journaling card that fits with the theme that totally matches perfectly. I've got other journaling cards and a lot of times I will pull them out, but I was really excited when I saw that. However, on the backside is their beautiful stripe paper, and I love stripes. So that is one reason. Oh, hang on, my battery is running low. I'm gonna go grab my cord. Be right back. Sorry about that. What I was saying though is, like, that is one good reason why I wouldn't mind having more of the 12 by 12 size papers, because there's such great designs on both sides. So, if I had to buy it again, if I wouldn't buy all of them again, but I would, like I said, for example, the journaling card one, so that I could cut up all those journaling pieces and use the stripe side as well. But I'm trying not to. You guys know my Spend Less, Scrap More series. I'm trying to be better. Here's where I'm going to struggle with my title. Before I talk about that, I'm going to talk about the way I did the photos. So I went off of the sketch as well, because Allison Davis has her four sketch or four photos kind of together in a cluster and all kind of crooked and clumped together. And side note, real quick here. This is my color album. I'm going to do a video. I get a lot of questions about how I do it compared to Janet from RTS. So I'm going to do a video and I'm going to talk all about these. So keep your eye out for that. It will be a few days, but I will answer any questions that you have about that. Okay. So I put my photos, I ended up adding them straight on there. I played around with the crooked of them being a little crooked, but one thing that I wanted was that one photo where he's holding up the fingers, the one and the two, to make the number 12. I really kind of wanted that to stand out from the rest of the photos. It does have a thicker photo mat than the other photos that I put a photo mat on. And I did do a different color behind each photo because I'm really having fun with that now. But I wanted those photos to not be so clumped together. I felt like it took away a lot from those photos. So I'm going through everything now. I have a color binder. I also have some sections that are like birthday and boy or animals, things like that. Again, I will do a video talking about those. But what I'm looking for now is something to go for the title. I wanted Happy Birthday, and I did not get the collection pack that has all the words with them. So what I did here was I took one of my alphabet dies, and I want to say shout out to Nicole Bingaman, because she's the one that gave me this idea. I cut the same alphabet die, the word birthday, every letter for the word birthday, three times from white cardstock and one time from the colored cardstock. So I'm basically making my faux chipboard. I do have a Tuesday 2-minute tip video on how to do this if you want to know more. But I'm just going to show you for just a moment here. And I zoomed in so you could see, just add a little adhesive and your letter is done. So, and I'm going to show you. I will also link to this alphabet die set. I don't label mine, and I want to say that might be from Honey Bee, but I wanted the word birthday and I didn't have it anywhere. And I didn't really want a black word because I found that word happy, which was, I probably would have never found that word happy if it wasn't in my color binder. So I was really glad that I found it because the colors are perfect. It's not a Doodlebug product, I'm pretty sure, but that green matches really well. So also, I'm going to take some of these Doodle Pops and I'm going to use some of these. And the clusters are going to be fairly simple on this layout. There's going to be a lot of the confetti. One of the things I love about this birthday collection is there's a lot of confetti, like pieces and circles and things to throw around. So I added this Doodle Pop. I wasn't sure about this number 12. I really wished it would have fit right above the A and the Y in the word birthday, but it just was too much on the photo. So I'm playing around with where it's going to go. It is a Doodlebug chipboard, that number 12, that it's a really, really old chipboard. They used to have a chipboard alphabet. And you guys know me, I'm trying to use up my letter stickers. So I tried finding different color, but all I could find was the orange. I know I have more, but I couldn't find them anywhere, but whatever. So I added the Doodle Pop, the cake down here. And now I wasn't really sure, and I kind of honestly don't like how much it sticks out. It kind of sticks, I don't know, it seems a little off to me, but by the time I add in all the little stuff around it, I really like that. But it's not my favorite right at this point. But once I put it there and I saw the little teeny candles that came with that Doodle Pop, I was in love. I thought, oh my gosh, this is so cute. And here's another thing I didn't think I would use is these people. So far on all the birthday layouts that I've done, I've added, except for the one that is the monthly celebration hop one, I didn't use any Doodle Pops on that. If as far as I can, no, I did. Never mind. I don't usually buy a bunch of Doodle Pops. I think I got this collection kit in a happy scrappy bag from my little scrapbook store, and it automatically came with a bunch of these Doodle Pops. And that was why I have all these, but normally I will pick and choose like one or two little Doodle Pops and call it good. But so now I'm going back and forth, and I finally decide just to commit and add the number 12 over here. I felt like it fit really well next to that monkey. I really like the way the monkey's kind of standing out there. It's almost, I think he has roller skates on, which is super cute as well. And he's holding that balloon. So I thought that was really cute. So I just made myself commit. I'm like, okay, I like it here. I'm not going to take forever. I was in a good mood. I'm liking it. So I'm just going to do it. I still wasn't crazy about the number 12 there, but I figured I'd come back to it later. Then I remembered these balloons. So this is part of the ephemera pack. I was talking a minute earlier that I didn't get the word ephemera pack, which I'm actually glad I didn't get the word one. I've noticed there's a lot of great title stuff, but it's more card based for card makers, I've decided. So I'm not real crazy about the word packs anymore. Plus, when I get those, I don't use up my alphabets, right? Like I wouldn't have used that happy from my color binder if I would have had that alphabet pack. So I decided to use some of these balloons and tuck them in behind the balloon that the monkey was holding, and I liked it so much. So I decided I was going to try to add some to this little boy's hand. So I pulled up that, it looks, I think it's a lollipop that he was holding, and I got a couple of them to fit. They are acetate, so I'm just adding one tiny little piece of glue dot behind the balloon. And in real life, I couldn't notice it. I do cover up that part of the balloon. And but even the one I put on the orange, I really didn't notice. And I'm just trying to make sure the strings go down into their hand. The one thing I did not care for was that some of the balloons didn't have a string. They were just like there, which I was kind of wishing they had a string just because I wanted to use them for this. So I kind of, you're going to see me play around. I really liked this fun one, But I didn't like how far up it went on the left-hand side. I don't know. It just seemed out of place, just the shape of it. I liked the shape of it and really wanted to use it, but it just wasn't happening. So I found another one with a string and I'm going to make it work and I'm going to end up tucking it and doing the same thing with it, just adding a little tiny glue dot and tucking it in there. And then I tried to use that little lollipop in his other hand or something, but it wasn't going to work. So again, I'm just taking a mini glue dot. And since it's tucked behind everything, you really don't notice the glue dot. So I don't even know if that string reaches to his hand. I'm not really that worried about it because the string is not that noticeable. But then I believe, excuse me, the last thing I'm going to do here, and oh no, it's not the last thing. One thing I found, so a lot of the Doodle Pops come with little separate little things, and that present was one of them. I think it might have came on the same package as the monkey. So I put it over the edge of the number 12 and I really liked it there. So I just put some foam tape around since that number 2 is a chipboard piece, it was lifted up. So I just added some foam tape kind of around the end of the 2 and put that present there, and it looks really good there, in my opinion. And that kind of took away from that bright orangeness coming from that corner. So I was quite happy with that. Now, here's where I'm going to play. And these are the confetti pieces that I was mentioning. And I'm going to just add these all over. I'm going to add those little swirly, like streamer pieces that are coming down. I'm going to add those into each cluster. I did decide because I felt like this cake needed something. There was like that blowhorn thingy and the other noisemaker toy. I added those coming out of the side of the cake. And my favorite spot probably ends up being right above the cake and the way that the stuff lands because it just looks like there's confetti falling all over the cake. It's pretty neat. And I did have these star stickers that also is part of this collection. And I'm taking basically one of each color and adding them to each cluster. I might add another one or two here or there. I know I add one to the strings of the balloons that the little boy is holding because of where I pulled that lollipop up. It did tear a little bit, but it's not that noticeable. So that is pretty much going to be the layout. The clusters are fairly simple, and I did my own thing, and I love how it turned out. So, thank you so much for watching. Oh, I am going to add another little cluster of confetti falling over here on the left-hand side of the journaling card. And I'm going to do my journaling off screen, but I believe you can see it in the layout. It just talks about it being his 12th birthday. So here is a few close-up photos. And I did put that hat on the boy. I did add a piece of foam tape underneath that so it would pop up on the boy's head. There's the little, looks like all the confetti falling on the cake that I really like. And here is the monkey kind of close-up. So I hope you guys like this layout. Again, thank you for so much for your kind and encouraging words. And I will see you guys next time. All right, hope you guys are enjoying this class as much as I am. Bye, everyone.